Virginia team that I've seen, and at least since Tony's been there. And he would be a much better opinion on that than me. But you know, defensively, they just don't have any weaknesses, and make it very difficult for you. And I thought we were a little intimidated in the first half, which really honestly kind of surprised me, because we've not shown that so much, I don't think. I mean, we've been beaten soundly, but a few times, but I haven't felt like we were necessarily intimidated. I thought we were a little intimidated in the first half. Missed some layups and missed some, you know, stuff right around the goal there, but you don't get many good shots against them, and then what happens is when you get a good one, then you rush it because you're thinking, gosh, we don't get many of these, better get this one, you know, try to get this one in the goal, and then you rush yourself. And but their defense is just phenomenal. It just is. There's nothing that you can really say, and you can try different things to get things to work. I thought we were a little better in the second half. I thought our pace was a little better. We were able to jump up and make some shots. But you have to make shots against them, and that's hard because they're great on that end.
Jim, what did you tell your team at halftime?
Told them I was disappointed because I thought that we were thought we had like a deer in the headlights look in the first half, and I didn't anticipate that. I hadn't seen that. I hadn't felt that. I didn't think that. I mean, gosh, if anything, we don't have anything to lose. We should just throw caution to the wind and play. And that's what I told him yesterday, and that was the message before the game. And obviously, it didn't help, and it didn't work. So, but like I said, we played a little better in the second half.
You know, knowing how Virginia plays defense, Kevin, and how you guys have struggled sometimes offensively this season, going into this game, what did you think was a realistic possibility for your team to do offensively? And was what happened in the first half about what you thought might have been the worst case?
Well, I didn't think the worst half was, or the first half was, I didn't see that coming. I didn't even think that could be the worst case. I thought at least we'd be better than that in the worst case. But, you know, they just don't have any weaknesses. And so really what it comes down to beat them, and not very many people have experienced this year against them, but you have to make shots, and you probably have to have somebody that can create and get to the lane that just has that kind of quickness to where they, as good as they are, you know, you've got that quickness factor against them. We don't have it. But anyway, it's hard to get them inside and, you know, trap you. And they rotate great out of it. And we tried to induce the trap a couple of times to beat them on it, and they didn't trap, and so, you know, they're an experienced group. They know that they know what you're trying to do to them, and he's a great coach. He's done an amazing job there, and just an amazing job, and this their team this year is amazing, I think.
Anything else? Coach, you have a lot of fans among us who are not only disappointed in the performance today, but throughout the entire season. If you have anything to say, what do you have to say to the fans and the alumnus?
I appreciate the fans that have come out in support of this team. I share in the disappointment in the way some of the things have gone, particularly, you know, the record for sure. I'm not disappointed in the attitudes and the coachability and the effort of our players. I feel like our players have given us what they have to give. You know, I share in some of that disappointment, but I certainly appreciate the people that have come out and been loyal and faithful to support this team.
Obviously, that's a particularly tough way to end your home slate in any season. guess, results-wise, has this conference play been for you, you know, going into it as opposed to where it is now?
Well, going into it, we thought we were going to have our best player, and the guy that's been through this a little bit. And you know, you go back to the last, well, the highly ranked team that we played with him. You know, Virginia comes, or West Virginia comes in here, and with 3 minutes to play, it's a 2-point game. Okay, and so then we lose him for the rest, you know, we didn't know it was going to be for the rest of the season. We ended up losing Ryan for the rest of the season. I didn't have expectations, you know, I kept expecting Ryan to come back. And then when it became obvious that he wasn't coming back, then I didn't have expectations because I didn't know how this team would be able to navigate without, you know, one guy that had been, have any semblance of experience through this league. And so we had some chances, you know, we certainly had a chance in here against NC State that, you know, we had a chance against Wake the other night, we had a chance down at Miami, we had some chances. And didn't get them done, it's not where we want to be. It's not where we're going to be, but I knew when I took the job that this was going to be a hard year. I didn't know it was going to be this hard. I didn't know that some of the dynamics that played out would play out the way they did, but we'll be okay. We're not a good team this year. It's not through lack of effort. It's not through lack of trying. We have to grow the program up again and get it better in every way.
Kevin, I know that there are a lot of decisions to be made that are out of your hands, but do you get any sense of anxiety coming into today that this might be my last game coaching this team in this building?
No, because again, I'm pretty good about not worrying about things that I don't control. You know, you tell that to your players, you tell that to your children. it was told to me, it was taught to me, and I don't control how long I coach here. I control how hard I work and what kind of job I try to do while I'm here. And that's all I can do. Those are my controllables. The others aren't controllables to me, so I don't spend a lot of time thinking about it.
Yeah, we've spoken with you throughout this season, Kevin, about, you know, how you feel like you're going to play with effort and some of that's continued even as some losses are getting out. Have you noticed your guys, even, you know, even just from your bench point, do you feel like you've gotten sort of progressively more disheartened maybe as the season's going on with each other?
Oh, I think there's, yeah, sure they've gotten disheartened. And understandably so, and to their credit, it hasn't kept them from coming out and practicing hard and working hard and being coachable and trying to improve and get better. But yeah, to have the season we've had is disheartening. I mean, it's disheartening for, you know, for all of us. Anybody that cares about the program is disheartening. I think that their response to it has been very admirable, and I really respect them for how they've gone about it and how they've handled it.
Last question.
I know you feel that the team can make significant strides in the offseason and next season. Mm-hmm. What gives you that kind of confidence?
Adding players to the mix that are experienced and have a proven track record of being able to have success on the court. Adding other guys to the team that provide some elements that we might not necessarily possess right now. And I think that when you can add some experience and some quality experience, I think that what ends up happening is, you know, the guys that are out there, Parker Stewart and Cam Davis and Shamil Stevenson, they all benefited when Ryan was playing, for instance. You know, the game was easier for them because Ryan Luther was on the court. And so we have some guys that make the game easier for these guys who are getting all these minutes right now and all this experience. And so, you know, you've got to believe that Terrell Brown will be a significantly improved player next year. He's certainly significantly better than he was to start the season. And you could go down the list and say that about a number of guys. So you've got a bunch of guys getting minutes this year, that if the program were in the kind of shape that we desire for it to be in, they wouldn't be getting these kind of minutes. They wouldn't. You don't want to have three or four freshmen starting games. They'd be coming off the bench, and you know Cam Davis would be playing 10 or 12 minutes a game behind a junior or senior and working his way up to where he could play a 20, be a 26 or 28 minute a game guy. Well, that's not the situation we're in. So, but back to your question, just adding guys that immediately make us better because they're more experienced and in some cases more talented. Thank you.
Thank you.